Ugly scenes have unfolded during a pride march at Melbourne's Midsummer Festival, with police officers pelted with paint bombs and hurled with abuse. Check it out. It's unbelievable. Let's bring in Victoria Police Chief Commissioner Shane Patton, who was caught in the chaos in Melbourne. Commissioner, thank you so much for your time this morning. Appreciate it. You are a straight talker, as I know. You do not mince your words. How did you feel being in the midst of that all yesterday?
Morning, Carl. It was very confrontational. For me, probably the word I think is disappointing. We're just disappointed that this group, this ugly rabble, took the opportunity to confront police, came there premeditated, confronted police through paint bombs, through missiles, abused us, but disrupted what should have been an event about pride, about inclusion, about diversity. And that's why we were there. 100 police employees, families. We had a police chaplain, unarmed, walking along to support the LGBTIQA+ community, and this happens. It was absolutely disgusting, really.
So what happened?
Well, we were in the march. As I said, there were police officers there. They had their children, were having a lovely day, going along, engaging with the community, walking along Fitzroy Street. Then this group of about 40 or 50 protesters, they encircled on three sides at the front of the march. They then began infiltrating into the lines. They encroached our personal space. They were being abusive. One of them was actually heard to say, effing shoot them. And now I don't think that was going to occur.
Wow.
But that's the type of vitriol we were exposed to. There were paint bombs being thrown. Many members were covered in pink paint. There were other missiles being thrown. We tried to walk around them. We'd been told they'd have a sit-in. We get the peaceful protest bit, but they didn't sit down. They were confrontational. We tried to walk around them. At that stage, it became a confrontation, and our public order response team tried to push them away and move them away. And that's what happened. Then we had a confrontation with them.
Commissioner, it looked to me like certainly that it was premeditated. Was there any organisation in it?
For me, I've said it was premeditated, and I say that because you don't make up paint bombs when you're standing in Fitzroy Street on the spur of a moment. They came there with an intent. That's pretty clear, and that was pretty obvious from the way they reacted. We had our police band out the front, our pipe band. They're going along playing music. They learned special music for this event, and they're not armed at all. They're wandering along in their kilt and their kit. We're getting great applause, and we're engaging with the community. We're waving flags. We're there to embrace and support the community, support our employees, show that we are there to work with the LGBTIQA+ communities, and this happens. Our band members were visibly upset. Afterwards, I know that many of our members were visibly upset. Those carrying their little kids. It should not have happened. It was really disappointing, and this ugly rabble of... They're not protesters. They just went there with an intent to confront us. We had one person who was one of that rabble who was arrested, and they'll be charged on summons with assaulting a spectator who was trying to help police. And one of our protective services officers, I'm told, suffered a minor injury to his shoulder. But as I said, many were covered in paint. We didn't want this to be about Victoria Police. We're one of numerous groups who were just there to participate and show inclusion, diversity, support, and show what a cohesive society we are. So this is really disappointing for us.
One seriously ticked off Chief Commissioner. Appreciate your time today. Thank you. Sarah.
Thank you.